Hey dosto, welcome back to my channel. Most of us prepare for each and every exam in the same manner. We generally do not focus on making a specific strategy for a particular exam. In this competition field, the strategy for each exam is different from other exams in one way or another. I have given Isro exam twice. First time I was far behind cutoff. In my second attempt, I made a specific strategy for Isro and cleared it. Therefore, I made this video to give you complete information related to ISRO exam, its syllabus, pattern, cutoff, and most important exam strategy. So guys, let's start. If you talk about electronics, this year there are 42 vacancies for ECE. Of course, it is around 5 to 6 times less than that of last year vacancies. But don't forget, you are an ECE student. 42 is actually a big number for us. Plus, since last 2 years, ISRO is recruiting for NTRO also. Many of you don't even heard about NTRO. ISRO don't mention about NTRO in their notification, but on the interview day, they will ask you whether you want to opt for NTRO or not, and definitely you will say yes. It means most probably 20-25 more vacancies will be there for you. Even IES has only 50 vacancies this year, and there is CIL and BRC also, which have a less number of vacancies for ECE, but students are actually preparing for these exams. So guys, it's very worthy to devote your time to your preparation, keeping ISRO in your mind. Speaking about these exams, here you can check out my video for complete guidance for BRC and CIL exam. ISRO exam is not like GATE exam. There will be 80 objective type questions, each of 3 marks, which you have to do in 2 hours. The maximum question will be of numerical approach, and maintaining speed with accuracy is very crucial here. And that's what maintain the level of this exam. Last year cutoff was 120 out of 240. And they call around 1200 students for interview for 216 vacancies. Roughly around 6 times they called. This year, as number of vacancies are less, cutoff may increase to 50-60%. This is the list of questions asked from each subject in ISRO written exam in 2015 and 16. Out of these subjects, in communication, focus was on digital modulation techniques, information theory, noise figure, link budget, and basics of coding. In EMFT, focus was mainly on transmission line, antenna, microwave is very important here, basics of radar, OFC. In EDC, maximum theoretical questions were asked in both years. In other subjects, just do the basics, no hi-fi concept required. Maths is important as you can see. You can skip material science and 8051 also, if you are not planning for IES. It's not gonna cost you anyhow. There will not be a single question from FT and English. Now, let's talk how to prepare for ISRO exam. First, go through ISRO previous 10-year papers. To get those papers, check out the description below. Make an effective strategy. Do not waste your time in reading books and class notes all over again. Ultimately, you have to solve questions. Solve these papers in a gap of 3-4 days and work on your weak points. These papers will give you an idea that what is the level of ISRO exam. The exam level will be below GATE only. Definitely, you will find some good questions of high level, but do not panic. Some questions are made just to waste your time only. This is very important as maximum questions are numerical and 80 questions in 2 hours look fine to many of us. But believe me guys, it is not. Even the 65 questions in 3 hours seems lengthy in GATE exam. So don't underestimate ISRO also. In my opinion, you have no need to buy any question bank from the market and do not fall into the trap of test series also. It's only a wastage of money. I followed this strategy last year and it proved to be very helpful to me. ISRO is not an unpredictable exam like GATE. Its level will be moderate. Many of you miss ISRO 2016 cutoff by few marks only. You all have very good chances this year. Don't miss this opportunity. Do not waste one more day. Exams like BRC, CIL, BEL, ISRO are coming. Forget about GATE now. It's gone. You can't do anything about it now. Start your routine again. You have roughly 2.5 months left. So you better start from today itself. All the best everyone. And if you haven't subscribed our channel, subscribe it guys. Comment your queries and suggestions below. Also comment guys what else you want through our next video. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned.